Today's a sad day. My dear bum colleague Paulie died. He always drank too much, and after he has won a whole day in the local borsel, he fucked his brains out and eventually died of a heart attack. But the good thing is, I got his heart! Hello everybody! Yes, you heard right, I got a human heart! No, just joking, it's a beef heart. But it's real, it's really a heart, and we are taking a look at it. Making a fucking mess here. This is actually a heart. The heart of a bull, a cow, I don't know. I don't even know if it's really of a bum, bull or a bum. But it was cheap, and it's a whole lot of meat, so why not cook it? What we're gonna do with it is, I don't even know if I can spell this. Beef bourguignon? Beef bourguignon. It's a French dish made from the finest beef, and we're gonna rape this dish and make it with a heart instead. So, the special thing about this is it's full of unnecessary fat and strings. We first get rid of those. Where to start? Just half it. This is not as disgusting as you may think. After all, it's a muscle. What's a steak and a shoulder and all the stuff you eat from an animal? It's all muscle. So here you have another muscle. Okay, it's a heart. So what? This is a rather complicated dish with, well, let's say not that complicated, but with many ingredients. But I just want to fuck it over. Fuck all the Frenchmen and rape their dish. So I chose it. If you have a flexible knife, take this. It's complicated with such a hard and stiff knife. So this is what we don't want. The fat needs to... Oh, the cat will eat it. You don't have to be 100% accurate, just remove most of the fat and the strings and you're good.
What's this? Oh, I better cut it off.
I don't know if you can hear this, but my cats are totally getting crazy over the meat that fell down. Those are the strings I'm talking about, they need to go. Ain't that tasty? Okay, now wash it. Now we got all those clean and filleted stripes of heart. I want to beat someone with this. I think I would enjoy this. Next step is to cut it in rather big stripes and put it into the pan. Okay, stupid French made this dish so complicated that I actually need to read what's up next. Those cubes need to be covered in flour. like this. We actually need a second pan. I wasn't that good prepared, as it seems. Heat up some oil. A lot of oil. It's sunflower oil, by the way. So now we can prepare the other thing we need. Into this we put some canned tomatoes without peel. While the oil is heating up, we take some big block of bacon and we remove the outer part because this is just the skin of the pig and we don't want to eat that. Also we can't, it's like chewing on a tire. And cut it into 4 cubes. Now we take each floured part of the heart and heat it up from up and down side, but just a few seconds. What we add into this big pan is star anise. I don't know if you've ever heard of it. It's bitter, a bit flowery. Is this even a word? Tastes like a flower, like a bitter flower. Into the pan. And laurel leaves, like standard laurel, laurel leaves. Two of them, and with a lot of lard we add the bacon. They are heating up on the downside, now we flip them over. While this is heating up, we are cutting celery. As you can see, there's a yellow part. This is not enjoyable at all. We remove this and only take the outer leaves. We are cutting those and we don't actually need to throw those in the trash. This can be cooked to a really nice consommé. Just this and chicken bones and you have a really nice consommé. But for this dish we don't need those leaves. We have another thing to cut, mushrooms. We don't need that much, just half of those. These are 400 grams, we take 200. And this is the reason why we don't need a scale. Those are 400, we take 200. This is the half. Easy, no need for a scale. I show you, it needs to be this brown before you flip them over. And we have another thing to cut while those are heating up. Onion! Okay, what next? Ah, we need consommé. Again, I only have instant because I don't know. It, as I just said, it's easy to cook a consommé, just some leaves and chicken bones or beef bones, easy, but I don't have it on storage and so we take instant. Okay, those are ready. Okay. Heat up some more oil. Now we add all the stuff we cut before. Okay, those tomatoes lost all its fluid, all the fluid that was around it, and we add it to the meat. The pan as hot as possible because we only want the outside to get almost burned. A dark brown. Now take some salt over the meat and flip it all over. Make sure the salt goes everywhere. This is how it looks so far. As you can see, bacon, meat, tomatoes, with salt. Once this is hot, we add some wine. This is red wine. It's the cheapest they had. This is 1.7 liters. We only need 1.5. So the rest is for the cook. Prost! I don't know, I'm stealing, but I still need to look for the cheapest, because when I get caught, I want to be able to afford it. And it's dry. Always use dry wine to cook. Fits together. Half and red wine. Okay, when this is getting brown, you see the mushrooms are getting brown. And also the celery has some brown parts. We add the wine. And this is where the magic happens. The fluid, the wine, needs to be reduced to the half of it. This happens by simply letting it on the stove. Could take a whole hour. Could only take 30 minutes. Just take a look at it now and then. And while we wait, we clean up all this shit. We take the vegetables out of the pan and add them to the meat. As you can see, I only take the vegetables, leave the red wine where it is, and we add the consommé to the red wine. We wait until this is half size. Okay, everything is clean again except of my swords, and the liquid has been reduced to the half just as intended, and we're gonna put everything together now. And we mix it all up. And now this gets in the oven for altogether 2 hours at 160 degrees. Heat coming from up and down in the oven, and only 1.5 hours with a top of it and 1/2 hour without. We remove it for the last half now. Here's a little update. I bet this happened before to you. You go into your kitchen and suddenly mushrooms with white wine. I had some leftovers from the mushrooms from before, 200 grams. And I also happen to have some white wine standing around, just a little bit. And now I fry them until all the white wine is gone, has been sucked up. This wasn't planned. Almost all the white wine is gone. Oh, by the way, I just added salt and pepper. Just keep them moving so they don't burn. And there we go. Here we have the unintended mushrooms. And we're back. Time for the final part. We get it out of the oven. And as you can see, this looks delicious. What we want out of it is the meat, of course. What remains in here is what will be the sauce. Therefore, we fill it into this thing with a lot of holes. We call it Sieb in German. And now we press every kind of liquid through the Sieb. Okay, that's it. This is now waste.
this is trash, throw it away.
Okay, and this sauce is getting heaten up for another 15 to 20 minutes. You have to constantly mix it so it doesn't burn. The sauce is ready. And we give it a taste. What can I say? It's perfect. There's all the vegetables, the wine, the strong taste of the meat. It tastes just strong in every regard. Wonderful. And just take a look at it. Does this even look like a heart? Looks like just some kind of beef. In the end, give this to your guests, and when everybody says, great, tasty, then tell them this is hard. Okay, one or another will puke all everything out, but that's hypocrisy. They eat it, they like it, and just because it's hard, oh my god, I have to puke. No, it's tasty, eat it. And if you don't like it, there's something wrong with you.